hey, all the boys are back. Big Dummy off Gibson, Mendes Lang, Windass, Gregory. It's all coming back at the same time. It's unbelievable. And this could be the icing on the cake, couldn't it? I mean, there's always that part of me, of course, that gets a little bit worried, because that's just what it's like being a Wednesday fan. I mean, anyone else is looking at it and thinking, this team's doing really well. It's like a beautiful big apple pie. And these quality players coming back is just like that lovely little sprinkle of sugar on top, do you know what I mean? But I always have that little part of me inside that thinks, well, this team's took ages to gel. Ages to gel. And now it has. Bringing too many players back in at once, would that upset the apple cart? Do you know what I mean? I mean, players, they've started getting used to certain runs, haven't they? Better he knows going to go in there. I know to clip that ball in there. Patterson's going to curve round here. I know to knock that ball in there. So they bring players in who haven't been part of that. Is it going to affect that balance and that rhythm that we built up? Like I said, on paper, it should be that lovely finishing touch getting these players back. But equally, can it cloud the waters? I mean, Darren Moore, what's he going to do? I mean, he's got some right decisions to make, hasn't he? And sometimes you can have too many options. I mean, we've put this run together and we've had all these terrible injuries. And that's shocking. The injuries have been shocking. You don't want that. But sometimes when you ain't got a choice, we'll have that. I mean, it's like when I now and again go out for a meal with our lass, you know. Waiter will come, have you decided? We'll give us 5 minutes, mate. And I'm like that, my menu, you know. And she's like, have you decided? I'm like, well, I've narrowed it down to 28. She's all fucking on fire. Waiter's coming back across, you know what I mean? She's going, have you decided yet? I'm going, ooh. Pick a number between 1 and 7. She's fucking on fire. I don't do that anymore, though, anyway, because what I twigged her, she was working out what the numbers were, so she was just going to make cheapest every time. Okay, no. So it's true, that. So now I pick my own. But I'm still not right good when I've got too many options, so I just have steak and ale pie. That's all I ain't going to go out. There's something comforting about a steak and ale pie, though. And that's why I'm not sure about dropping Callum Patterson, you know. I mean, he's a steak and ale pie of a footballer. There's something comforting about seeing him in there bashing people about. Another thing is Lee Gregory. I think he's worked best with the big lad. I thought his best games have been with Canberra. Now, folks can say what they want about Canberra. He doesn't score enough goals. Second touches a tackle and all this bit. But I think Gregory's best performances have come with that big lad alongside him. So could he play with Patterson and get a similar sort of result, but maybe even better? I'd be tempted with that partnership myself. Would that be harsh on Berahino's come in and a couple of really, really top quality finishers and looking a bit more like the player we thought we were signing when we got him? I think Gregory's got to play, though. He's got to play. And I'm really excited about that because he's our top scorer. He's got, 8 goals? You know, decent record. But he scored them goals when we were playing shit. When we were doing all that tip-tap funny about the back. But now we've got Marvin Johnson on the left, where he belongs. And the sort of quality and delivery that he's putting in box. I mean, his crossing, the variation on his crossing. Flippers. Curved ones to back stick, low ones to near post, some in behind defence, some just over defender's head. I mean, the range, some at pace, some with backspin. The quality of his delivery this last few months has been unbelievable. I mean, has he got 5 assists in the last 7 games, something like that? And I'm just looking at that and thinking, Lee Gregory could have a bloody birthday here. He could have a birthday. I'm looking at this game and thinking, he could get an hat-trick. Dead easily. It could be a comeback hat-trick for him. But do you start him? Do you start him? I mean, Darren Moore has looked after the players. Got to stick up for him for there. So will he start him? It's a gamble, innit? I mean, there's always that temptation to, you know, just wrap him in cotton wool a bit. But he's a goal scorer. You've got to pick a goal scorer. You've got to... Especially results went against us overnight. I think just about every result that could go against us went against us, you know. So we've dipped down to 8th in table. And there's another thing I don't like look of here and all, and that's Portsmouth. I've been saying it for about 3 or 4 weeks. I've just got a dark horse feeling about them. They're just quietly going about their business. Winning, winning, winning. I mean, they were well off at pack, and now they've just come into the scene at bottom. Don't like that at all. Especially as, well, I'm not even going to get into that end game of season and where their goals are coming from. Jesus. Right, focus. Cambridge. Let's have a look at Cambridge. Cambridge United's one to watch is Joe Ironside. It's a good old-fashioned name, isn't it? Sounds like a private detective. Joe Ironside, PR. Anyway, 28-year-old. Position, whee, nice and refreshing. Centre-forward, not an attacker. Okay, you know. Centre-forward, great stuff. Right-footed, 34 games. He's their top scorer, 13 goals. Just the 3 assists, don't know if he's agreed yet, but we'll find out on the day, I suppose. Someone will have to keep an eye on their main goal threat, Joe Ironside. Looks quite handy, didn't play it other week though, so I do wonder if maybe he's got a couple of niggles or injury worries, something like that. It could be a bonus for Wednesday. But he's the one to keep an eye on. Let's have a look at their most recent results. Cambridge United's last 4 results, a 2-0 win against Plymouth Argyle, bit of a turn up for books there. Mind you, Plymouth, they've been up and down, haven't they, since Lowell left. Let's hope they can get a few more downs, actually, and do us a favour. Then they lost 4-2 in the boat race derby against Oxford. A 3-0 spanking away against Wickham Wanderers. And most recently, a 0-0 draw against Shrewsbury Town, which all things considered is probably not a bad result for them. Tactically, what are they going to do? Well, they might change it. You can never tell what team's going to do. We expected Lincoln to go with 4-4-2 because that's what Appleton have been using every week. Play Wednesday, changes it. But this is how Cambridge have been playing. Cambridge have been lining up with a 4-2-3-1. Obviously, Ironside up top, the danger man we've talked about, the main goal threat. Don't need to tell any Wednesday fans though about their number 14 in there, Wes Houlihan. Seems to have been around for years. He's got to be as old as me if he's a day. 7 assists this season, only played 23 games, I don't know if he's been injured, but still got that quality, you know, nearly setting up a goal a game just under there, so he's someone to keep an eye on. 5 across the midfield, obviously again, that's going to be another area where Wednesday, Lincoln did it to us, matched us with 5 across the middle, they did it with 3 at the back. So again, it could be a tight game, going to be vital that Wednesday can score that first goal.
This could be a tight game. What am I on about? Jesus.
These aren't 1-6 away games, aren't spin. I mean, they've got 2 draws and 4 defeats in the last 6 away games. Wednesday's got one of the best home records in the entire league. Got Mendes Lang, Iofa, Gregory, Windass, all back. I mean, you add these 3 things together. Their away form, our home form, our top quality players coming back. I mean, it only points to a massive Wednesday win. But then again, everything about the Lincoln game pointed towards a massive Wednesday win. And we got pasted 3-1. That's why bookies are swimming in money and we're not, aren't it? No, I mean, it should be a Wednesday win. It should be. And we need to win because we're down in 8th. We've got to claw back up into that top 6 and keep amongst them teams around us. So it's a must-win game. It's a game we should win. But I really wouldn't like to try and predict what's going to happen. 4-0 Wednesday. Gregory hat-trick. Come on, boys!